and then I want to go home and eat either.
Yeah, that's true.
Huh? Yeah, I get my head, but this kind of stuff, my head, this.
It's
getting
bigger.
I've never seen one swollen.
I don't like this. There's not much there.
Mm-mm. It's going to be a beautiful color of purple, you know.
Well, Terry was kind of upset that her husband was so sick. He's got a bunch of medicine.
Oh, no. Is he quite a bit older than her?
Girl to me. You're all girls to me.
Not that far behind you.
No, come on. The 15th girl of us might be 55, 60, 75 years old. It is, what did I say?
75.
You're right. I have.
Well, good afternoon and welcome to St. James Catholic Church here in Liberty. It's nice to see some new faces. So welcome today. To those joining us online, thank you. We're happy to have you with us. It is my pleasure and privilege to introduce our guest artists today. On trumpet, we have Dustin Williams. And on piano and organ, we have his wife, Julie. And so without further ado.
Thank you. next piece, Julie will be playing on organ solo, and it is a crowd prelude on St. Peter, arranged by the organ. Thank you, and enjoy. She's walking over here. I'll talk about the next piece a little bit. The next piece is a famous cornet solo called Fantasy Brilliant, and it's an introduction, theme, and variation. So you'll hear some pretty dramatic music at the beginning, then a pretty lovely, simple tune, and then it goes a little haywire from there. But the melody was a popular tune from the late 1800s, and it was common for brass bands and concert bands to arrange music for soloists, the principal players in each section, and these theme and variations were a popular way to do that. So please enjoy Fantasy Brilliant by Jean-Baptiste Arban.
Thank you.
did want to mention, before we go on, 10 years ago, plus a couple of weeks, Julie and I were married, and 10 months, or sorry, about 6 months before that, we decided it was a good idea to plan and perform a recital right before we got married. It was not a good idea. It was fun, but it was not a good idea. And it just so happens that now we're expecting a child, and we again thought it would be a good idea to plan and prepare a recital, and this time I think it was a little bit better. But we did play that piece on that same recital, so it's fun to bring that one back again. But thanks.
I will now play a set of three pieces written in the Romantic and Modern periods that each convey a great deal of beauty and angst, much like the current world in which we are living. The first piece I'll play today is the opener of Claude Debussy's Children's Corner Suite to the whimsical and finger-twisting Dr. Gratus ad Parnassum. Debussy dedicated this piece to his daughter, writing, "To my dear turbulent opening and ending that is so fitting for this uncertain time that instead I will play the middle largo section, which beautifully accompanies the hymn, All That Thrills My Soul Is Jesus, reminding me that, especially in unsettling times like right now, Jesus is what we need." The final piece in my set is the beautiful and captivating Romance in D-flat major, number 9 of Opus 10 by Jean Sibelius. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Does all right, doesn't she? The next piece we're playing is entitled Centennial Horizon. This is a relatively new piece written for trumpet and piano by Kevin McKee. He's currently living and very, very active. He writes a lot of great, brilliant trumpet music. This particular piece was written, I believe, for his grandmother, and it was meant to depict three scenes in Colorado, which we loved going there. And unfortunately, this year our annual trip was not possible. The brass band and plane was canceled, and you know the rest. So this first piece is called the Aspen Grove. So imagine yourself in the forest. And when you know this, if you've been in an aspen forest, it's basically aspen trees and nothing else. So it can be beautiful and stunning, but also a little bit scary if it's maybe twilight, or if you get up when you're camping at 2 o'clock in the morning to visit the restroom or something like that. So this movement encompasses a lot, all of those feelings. There's another interlude and another movement, which we won't be playing today, but those depict a river, and they're a lot more exciting and whatever. But this is a lovely little movement, and we hope you enjoy Centennial Horizon by Kevin McKee.
Thank you.
And that brings us to our final piece of the afternoon. This is a popular song that we love playing together. It was performed at our wedding. We perform it at weddings. We play it for fun all the time. And it is "Someone to Watch Over Me." And it is arranged by the great Joseph Turin, who has arranged pieces for the New York Philharmonic and the New York Philharmonic's principal trumpet player, former principal trumpet player, including this piece, Philip Smith. So typically his music is kind of wild, but this one's just sweet, and we hope you enjoy "Someone to Watch Over Me."
Speak for everybody here that we are better for having witnessed this today. And it was so nice to be able to escape from some of the darkness and things that we see outside, to just be able to come in and enter into a sense of peace and familiarity with both of you. So thank you for giving us the opportunity to listen to such beautiful music. Truly, it was a blessing. Thank you very much. Really. Thank you to everyone who came today, and thanks for everyone who's joined us online. We are so grateful to you. Next Thursday, we have our next performance at 12 o'clock. We will feature our very own baritone, Nicholas Baumert. Nick Baumert grew up in the choir here at St. James and is in his sophomore year at UCM studying music. So he will be joining us next Thursday and singing for us. So thank you. Thank you again. God bless and have a great day.